Good morning. It's 6:45. It's a Monday, the 7th of November. And as you can see, it's raining. But I think it's 56 degrees. Made it into the 70s yesterday. Went out with the Snowmobile Club and did some brushing on trails, clearing blackberry thorn bushes and small trees along the trail just east of the Springfield Fairgrounds, and then Kevin and Tyler Lee took in five planks to repair a bridge, and these planks are 4 inches thick by 12 feet long by a foot wide, and they're heavy. Tyler had access to a an excavator, and Tyler lives right near the fairground, so he let Kevin use his Can-Am ATV, and there's a bunny rabbit. Kevin tied a rattan chain around the five planks and pulled them into the bridge. I was impressed that the cannon pulled that kind of weight. Lynn. Lynn, you're not going in there. Come on. Lynn, come on. Leave him alone. Lynn, come on. So it was me and Kurt doing the brushing. And Kevin and Tyler working on the bridge. Tyler used the excavator to clear some debris that was under the bridge, causing the water to rise. And then they repaired a culvert. So, too bad they didn't have more people turn out to help. But they got it done. Kurt's a little bit older than me, and I'll be 70 next week. Kevin, I think, is 60 or 62, so 3 out of the 4 working on with senior citizens. Tyler's a younger man, probably in his late 30s, early 40s, so it's good to have his help and it's his access to machines. There was one tree, well actually several trees, across one area that were blocking the trail. Kevin cleared one, and Kurt was cutting off after he brought it down, but there's a bigger one that Kevin was trying to get ready to clear, And that one almost fell on Kevin. It actually fell, but Kevin was able to get out without getting hit by the tree. And Tyler used the excavator. He's got a thumb on the bucket. He used that excavator to pick up the tree pieces. We cut it down to manageable sizes. We used the excavator to move that debris out of the way. Flint, come on. Come on. And then I had Kevin's drone, not Kevin O'Brien, but Kevin Leo Wirt. Probably butchering his name. I had his drone. They were supposed to stop by Saturday to pick it up, but they didn't. Well, I'm out brushing the trail. Sandy sent me a message saying they'll stop by at 11. So I told her, texted her that I was out working on trails. So after the trail work is done, I went over back to the house, got his drone, went over to their property on Tar Ridge, gave him the drone, and had a beer, chatted for a while. And headed home. So it was a good day. The park camp is looking worse and worse. Oh, forgot to mention when I oversee Kevin and Sandy. I had come back from brushing. I took 169 up to Tar Ridge, and I got over past Jim and Gail's house, Wayne, and I can't remember his wife's name. They have a tree farm there on the south side of Tar Ridge. And Wayne was out there with a game warden. And didn't know what was going on. Kevin and Sandy told me that they had come in. Oh, coyote. See it? If there's one, there's more. Anyway, they had come in hours earlier, or an hour earlier, and there was a fire right just up the road by Wayne's tree farm. They banged on Wayne's door to get him out of the house, and got rakes and shovels to put the fire out. Went west on the power line there. Fit the coyote. Might have been eating the apples out of the scat. I guess I should have had Flynn's coat on, his raincoat. Looking for tracks, I don't see any. That's weird that that critter could run up here and not leave any tracks. Yeah, we'll see it on the power line. Which one? Flynn. Truck. Well, I didn't expect rain today. Thought the forecast said partly cloudy. Come on, buddy, take care of business, huh? Flynn's leaving tracks, but didn't see any from the coyote. Blaze orange hunting hat is getting soaked. I can feel the water starting to come through the denim jacket. Flynn, come on. Flynn. Degrees, I'm not having an ice form on me. It almost looks like a trail going through here. see right there. Do his business, but he's too busy smelling coyote. Hey, good one. Goodbye. Tomorrow I have to be in Old Town to get new tires on the truck at noon. Not sure how long it's going to take. It's probably going to be an hour and a half. So that'll put me back up here around 3 o'clock. Thank you. Keep shaking my head because there's raindrops on the brim of the hat. Looks like that there's a worm there. Big one there. Focus on the tree that's got caught the last of the limbs. I want to see if I can extract a picture and send it to a couple of people so they can tell me what kind of tree it is. I'm thinking hemlock. But I'm Not a tree guy. There's a woodpecker there. Looks like the one that, well, it's similar to the one that was in the barn. Crapped all over the place. Play note. But that's a tree. Looks like the rain is letting up. It's too late because the sun's already soaked. There were coyotes down on the northwest corner there overnight. I haven't heard any of them. Now tomorrow's election day. So I'll take the wife down to vote. And then bring her back. Gotta get my tires. Just a flag making noise. I don't know if there's something in the bush. Don't know whether that hair stayed. Nope, there it is. Stayed right under the pine tree. Back where Flynn first saw him. Flynn's like, let's go, I'm wet. That drive me off. Well, that's it for this morning's video. I guess this is raining and all. Make some blueberry muffins. I got a pound of blueberries in the refrigerator. I'll go bake those up for my freezer. Oh, try Flynn off first. Gonna leave you a leash on you right now, buddy. Thanks for watching.